Hello friends, my name is Amruta Haldankar. Welcome to my session wherein I'm going to deal with ITA areas of the world. So ITA has divided the world into certain areas, but before going to ITA areas of the world, let us get a recap on what the world actually is. All right. So behind me, you can see the world map. So this is how our world looks. If we want to know the major areas and the major continents that most of the geographers are dividing the world into, we can start from this side. The starting would be from Pacific Ocean. If we can say this is North, so this is North Pacific Ocean and this becomes the South Pacific Ocean. We have the continent of America over here. This entire continent is known as North America. We have Central America on this side. We have certain islands over here which are known as the Caribbean areas. We have this continent which is known as South America. We have another ocean on this side which is known as the Atlantic Ocean. This part is known as North Atlantica and this part is known as South Atlantic Ocean. Further ahead, we have Europe. These are the European countries. So this is the Europe continent. We have the Middle East continent, which is on this part. We have the continent of Africa. If we move further ahead, we have the continent of Asia. And we have India right here. We have Indian Ocean over to this side. This continent, this area, which is known as the Oceania, is the Pacific areas and the islands in it. Further, we have again Pacific Ocean, which goes in continuation on this side of the world map. So this entire is our world as we know it. But as we know that ITA, for taking care of air ticket and civil aviation, has divided the world not into continents, but into IATA areas. So let us have a look at what these areas are and what all things it includes. So IATA has divided the world into IATA areas, which are three major areas. So this is what the division is. This is ITA Area 1, ITA Area 2, and ITA Area 3. It is also known as Traffic Conference Area 1, Traffic Conference Area 2, and Traffic Conference Area 3. All right. So when earlier we have seen the world map, it is similar to that basis. That is, if we imagine the world to be divided into these areas, the North American continent will be in Area 1. The Europe, African, and Middle East will be in Area 2. And the Asia and the Southwest Pacific area would be in Area 3. All right. So let us see what further ahead we are included in all these areas, because these are further going to get divided into more sub areas. Now let us concentrate on the sub areas first. We will concentrate first on IATA Area 1 or Traffic Conference Area 1, which gets divided into further sub areas. Now for dividing further, what has IATA done is that there are two types of classification or two types or bases of classification. In the first basis, it has got divided into four sub areas. So we have North America, we have Central America, we have Caribbean areas, and we have South America. So basically here, in this first classification, the ITA has divided the sub areas as per the geographical points, that is trying to divide it as per the continents or the areas. In second classification, it has done a straight off cut of the surface. For example, it will be in the northern region, middle region, and the south region. So this will be North Atlantic, which is also known as NATL. It will be Mid-Atlantic, MATL, and this will be South Atlantic, SATL. So these are the sub areas of IATA Area 1 under both the classification, Classification 1 and Classification 2. Let us check the list of countries under North America now. This is North America. We can see the countries of Canada, USA, Mexico, and the Saint Pierre. Now let us check the list of countries under Central America. This is the region of Central America, and these are the countries which are included. Now let us move to the list of countries which fall under Caribbean area. This is Caribbean area, which are the islands which are included here. Now let us check the list of countries under South America. This is the zone which is included under South America. These are the countries which will be there. Now let us move to the second classification group, wherein first we will check what are the countries which may be included in North Atlantic. Now this is a zone which is included under NATL. We have approximately similar countries over here as in the first classification. Now let us check the list of the countries which may be included in Mid-Atlantic. Now this is the zone which is included in the Mid-Atlantic sub-area. Let us check the list of the countries which are falling under South Atlantic sub-area. South Atlantic sub-area will include these countries which are also known as ABCPU. So these are the countries which are included in South Atlantic sub-area, which are slightly different than South America, which was earlier the classification. Now let us check ITA area 2. Alright, now the ITA area 2 gets divided into more sub-areas. Sub-area number 1 would be Europe. Next, it would be the continent of Africa and the Middle East. So Europe basically will be all the countries which come under the European continent. Africa will again have the same. And Middle East will be a part which comes under Middle East subcontinent. The Africa gets divided into more sub-areas. Now let us check how the Africa, that is the sub-area in ITA area 2, further divided into more sub-areas. Here you can check there are 6 sub-areas or zones which Africa gets divided into. First zone will be Central Africa. Clearly it includes all the countries which are in the central zone of Africa. Next is the Eastern Africa, which includes the countries which are on the eastern side of the continent. Further ahead we had Southern Africa. The point to be noted here is that it is Southern Africa and not South Africa, because South Africa is a name of a country, but whereas when we say it's Southern Africa, we are talking about a zone in south side or southern side of African continent. Next we have Libya, which includes only one country, which is Libya. Indian Ocean islands will include a group of islands which are placed in Indian Ocean. And the next one is Western Africa, which includes all the countries which are on the western zone of Africa. So this will be the entire division of how ITA area 2 gets divided. So just to recap, Europe, Africa, which gets divided into 6 zones again, and Middle East. Now let us check these areas one by one and check what are the list of countries which are included. Now let us first concentrate on which are the countries or the list of countries under the sub-area of Europe. This is the part which is included in Europe. These are the countries which fall under European continent. Now, what we need to know special mention here is about the countries of Algeria, about the country of Morocco. If you can see, the location physical would be in the continent of Africa, but they are considered to be a part of Europe. The same goes for Tunisia, which is also, if you can see, physically located in Africa, but it is considered to be a part of Europe ITA area. So this is Morocco, Algeria, and Tunisia. Further ahead, we can also see Russia on this part, which is included as Russia in Europe. So the part before Ural Mountains would be considered as a part of Russia in Europe. We also have the country of Turkey, which sometimes might be seen to be closer to Middle East culture, but it is considered as a part of Europe. So these are the regions which come under Europe. Now let us concentrate on Africa, the sub-area, under which the first sub-area or sub-zone would be the Central Africa. Let us check which areas or which countries are included here. Now this is where Central African countries are located. Central Africa has Malawi, Zambia, and Zimbabwe. So we have this country which forms under Central Africa. Let us now concentrate on the list of countries which are under Eastern Africa. Now, these are the countries which are located under Eastern Africa. As you can see, it will be on the eastern side of African continent till Tanzania. Let us now concentrate on the list of countries which are included under Southern Africa. these are the countries which are coming under Southern Africa. As you can see, this will be on the southern tip of African continent. Let us now see which are the countries which are there in Libya, which is only one country. This will be Libya, which is the only country which is included in Libya, the sub area under Africa. Let us now check the list of the countries which are in Indian Ocean islands. Now, these are the island nations or the major islands which fall under Indian Ocean islands. So, if you can see Madagascar, the bigger one, and Mauritius, which falls under here. Let us now see the countries which are included in Western Africa, the subgroup. These are the countries which fall under Western Africa. As you can check, these are in Western zone of African continent. So, these are the groups which form Western Africa. Now, let us check the countries in Middle East. We have this zone as Middle East countries in Traffic Conference Area 2. The most notable ones to remember is Egypt, North Sudan, and South Sudan. All these three countries are physically present in African continent but are considered to be a part of Middle East ITA area. That was area 2 for you. Now let us move ahead with what is happening in TC area 3. Now, Traffic Conference Area 3 gets divided into 4 zones or 4 sub-areas. The first one here would be known as Southeast Asia, that is Southeast Asia, which is also known as SEA. The next group of the countries which will be known as South Asian Subcontinent. Now, ideally South Asian Subcontinent would be India and its neighbor. Roughly speaking, Southeast Asia would be the Singapore, Malaysia, Thailand zone. Now, the next one which we have is JAPCOR. JAPCOR stands for Japan and North and South Korea. So, these are the countries which are included in this particular sub-area. And the last group of countries which are included is in Southwest Pacific. So, ideally, we are talking about Australia and its neighbors. So, that will be Southwest Pacific. So, that is how the sub-areas gets divided into IATA Area 3. Okay. So, let us further go ahead and check what are the list of countries under the first zone, which is Southeast Asia. Now, these are the regions which are under Southeast Asia. So, typically Southeast Asian countries will be here and some of them are also over here. So, Turkmenistan, Uzbekistan, which fall under this particular region. So, this will be Southeast Asia. Now let us check the list of countries which fall under South Asian subcontinent. This is a zone which will be included under South Asian subcontinent sub-area. You can roughly decide that India and the neighbors, this will be the countries which fall under South Asian subcontinent sub-area. Now let us check what is coming under JAPCOR region. This is the country which is going to fall under JAPCOR or Japan, North Korea, South Korea. So, these are the three countries which are included in the JAPCOR sub-area of Area 3. Let us now check the countries and the list of the countries which are included in Southwest Pacific area. These are the countries which will fall under Southwest Pacific sub-area of Area 3. So, you can roughly decide this as Australia and the neighboring islands. So, this will fall under Southwest Pacific area. Now, those were the list of countries which were included in IATA Area 3. So, that was entire world divided into IATA areas. Just a quick recap for you. This is how IATA areas look like. So, IATA can divide the entire world into three: IATA Area 1, IATA Area 2, and IATA Area 3. It is also known as Traffic Conference Area 1, Traffic Conference Area 2, and Traffic Conference Area 3. IATA Area 1 here will be divided as per two classification. In the first classification, it gets divided into four sub-areas. We have North America, Central America, Caribbean area, and South America. On the second classification basis, it gets divided into three different sub-areas. The first one would be North Atlantic sub-area, second one would be Mid-Atlantic sub-area, and the third one would be South Atlantic sub-area. After going through this particular area, we move to IATA Area 2 or TC2. We get sub-areas, which are three of them: Europe, Africa, and Middle East. Further ahead, Africa itself gets divided into six subsections, which we have Central Africa, Eastern Africa, Southern Africa, Libya, Indian Ocean Islands, and Western Africa. To remember it correctly, you can just remember which one is not there. So we have East, South, and West. We do not have North. All right, so that's how you can remember the six sub areas. Next is the Middle East, which is a part of Traffic Conference Area 3. Now, what we have on this side is Traffic Conference Area 3, so which is further divided into four sub areas. The first one is Southeast Asia, second one would be South Asian subcontinent, third one the JAP core, and fourth is a Southwest Pacific. So that are the ITA areas and how the classification is done of each countries. I hope this session on IATA areas of the world was helpful. For any further clarification, you can find me on LinkedIn. Have a nice day.